ورحمة الله وبركاته. Good day to all. This is Dr. Sana Farid, and I welcome you all to the Harvard Business Review and Malafi webinar titled Unlocking the Value of Connected Healthcare. I'm a general surgeon, co-founder of Munfarid, and the president and the digital healthcare chair at the VRAR Association. Immersive tech, intelligent connectivity, and digital healthcare strategies are opening new doors for major revolution in the healthcare system. For example, a program in Abu Dhabi, Malafi, is successfully connecting patients' data across private and public hospitals. If we picture a vision of the future of healthcare, this is what we are preparing for. A future where doctors and patients are very well connected. This will enable the early diagnosis of health issues by constant monitoring before the issues become more serious. A future where heart diseases can be prevented in a whole new way, and robots help the aged live more independently. We also picture a vision of the future where asthma and some lung cancers are a thing of the past, with the advancement in technologies like nanomedicine that can also cure blindness and even cancer. All of these promises are becoming a reality with the tireless efforts of the policymakers aiming for better coordination of care. We are delighted to have with us today some of the most reputable experts driving the digital transformation in Abu Dhabi. Please join me to welcome Dr. Hamed Al-Hashimi, Director, Strategy Division at the Department of Health, Abu Dhabi. Mr. Badr Al-Qubaisi, Chief Information Officer at the Abu Dhabi Health Services Company, Sahha. And Mr. Atif Al-Braiki, Chief Executive Officer, Abu Dhabi Health Data Services, Malafi. Thank you all for your valuable time to discuss unlocking the value of connected healthcare. As we focus on patient centricity, the regulation of disruptive technologies, appropriate responses to ethical challenges, and the promotion of the use of digital health. UAE is amongst the international pioneers to implement digital healthcare strategies. Dr. Hamed, would you like to start about describing how is the Department of Health driving the innovation in the healthcare?
First of all, thank you, Dr. Sana. Thank you, Harvard Business Review, for hosting me for this event. And it's a great pleasure to be with you here today. First of all, no doubt that we are already the digital age, and we have seen it is already transforming the healthcare industry in different dimension, and with the desired outcome in terms of having an impact in our society, in our population, so that we making sure that our people staying healthy, getting better, as well as sustaining their health. Now, for Abu Dhabi and the Department of Health, we are focusing on introducing the digital health and making the transformation that happens across the ecosystem. And we're focusing in four areas. And this is where we anchor our transformation into, first of all, whatever we do, we make the people at the heart of what we are doing. So when we introduce technology, what it matters for us is the impact that we're going to have on the population. We want also to be ahead of the game when it comes to digital transformation. And one aspect that we have done, which you mentioned, Malafi, we have created Malafi as a health information exchange, connecting different facilities across the ecosystem. And also we are having in our launch pad different programs, different solutions that we're going to introduce, and we're going to have a discussion around it soon. The third anchoring point is agility and collaboration. And this is, has been proven that agility and collaboration is very crucial when we manage the COVID, and that will go also with us after the COVID in terms of how we co-design, co-create the future with the healthcare in Abu Dhabi in partnership with the different players, whether the typical players like the providers, the facilities, the payers, and then as well as most important also the technology partners who are already getting into this area and having a transformation from introduce different transformation across the healthcare industry. The fourth point, the anchoring point on how we are moving forward is we have a concept where we want to bring healthcare into one platform. Hence, we want all the data elements, the different solutions, the different analytics will be coming into one platform, and hence we're creating this kind of connectivity across the different players in the system. And I'm going to mention much more about this once we get into this webinar. And Abu Dhabi, I want to emphasize, is very much committed in terms of introducing a new model of care where digital becomes an anchoring point where we transform the different dimension of the healthcare, where again, we with the sole objective of having the right impact on our society by making sure that they're staying healthy. So this is, we're moving more into the prevention of care and the well-being. We want the second value proposition is how to make sure that our people getting better. This is what's whenever they get into the treatment in the hospitals, we need to ensure that the latest technology, the latest solutions are available on, at the hand of the providers. The third element is about staying healthy. And this is very crucial for us. It's about we extending the value proposition from getting better treatment from the hospital. So we're covering the prevention. And then the third leg, which is how to make sure that people are staying healthy. And hence, we want to bring care to home. And this is by the use of the different various solutions and technology with the that will benefit the chronic disease, but as well as other situations.
Thank you very much, Dr. Hamid. It's very essential and glad that you mentioned about patient centricity, because connected, and today during the webinar, this is what we will learn, that why connectivity is so important in digital health. This is not something new for Abu Dhabi when we talk about connectivity and digital health. With Saha's digital facilities, for example, Cerner, Saha has successfully launched a connected healthcare network. Mr. Bader Al-Qubaisi, how did that help the end user? The end user being medical care providers, doctors and nurses, as well as the patients.
First of all, thank you for this invitation, and it's our pleasure to be here. As you know, that today Saha is one of the largest largest healthcare provider since the establishment of Saha as the major health provider. Our goal was to have to implement the government vision and to be as a patient centricity. Mentioning that we provide a healthcare, we built a healthcare system that provide one patient, one record. And since then, we have like one EMR, central EMR that that provide all the services to the doctor and to the nursing. The good things with the central EMR that we have, we know our patient, we know their history. So that will help improve the patient safety and provide better patient care.
Thank you, Mr. Bader. As per, I have the statistics from 2017 released by the Federal Statistic and Competitive Authority. There were 45 hospitals in the government, but almost double, 98 hospitals in the private sector in Abu Dhabi. Malafi surfaced as a bridge to eliminate the gap in connectivity between the private and the public sector. Mr. Abaf, being an innovator, can you please address the phased rollout approach to implement Malafi?
Sure, and first of all, Dr. Sana, I'd like to thank you and Harvard Business Review and all the audience for spending also your time today with us. If you look at the challenge of the private sector, you know, it all started with 15 years ago when Abu Dhabi government you know, there was a reform of introducing mandatory insurance across the sector, and that increased access, and private players started playing a bigger role in providing healthcare services in Abu Dhabi. But then you started getting also challenges of care coordination. So the minute you have many private system or healthcare providers with different organizations providing care to the same patient who is moving between public facilities being Sahha, going to NMC, MediClinic, VPS, and different private providers, care coordination really became a challenge. The other challenge was also the rise of cost due to repetition of tests unnecessarily, where that cost can potentially be invested in further enhancing the quality of care. There was some waste of repeating unnecessary tests due to not having or providing the providers with the right level of information when they see the patient. So from the beginning, the Department of Health had a very clear strategy of how to enable or use digital health or using digital to tackle that problem. So a health information exchange initiative started to become discussed at the Department of Health. And in 2018, they established Malafi and an operating company to build this platform, which basically connects with all the electronic medical record systems that are used across the different healthcare facilities in Abu Dhabi. And with the simple target of really connecting healthcare, making sure that every citizen or resident in Abu Dhabi has a unified medical record that is accessible to any healthcare providers that patient sees. Today, we have connected more than 700 healthcare facilities across the Emirate of Abu Dhabi. We have more than 70% of the market episodes that are happening today, or medical episodes that are happening in the market. All are coming through Malafi, and we are able to build this unified medical record view of the patient, embedding it through the electronic medical record of those healthcare providers. This really is today enhancing the coordination of care across the different healthcare providers. And there are different initiatives also that we are currently working on empowering the patient by having simple and easy access to their unified medical record. One of the key strategies that the Department of Health has clearly mandated us to do is to make sure that every resident should have access to their unified medical record, and information should be easily available to the patient. And this is one of these future initiatives that Malafi is currently working on to ensure that the patients also are going to be empowered with their own electronic medical record.
Thank you, Mr. Atif. Going back to Mr. Bedr, as Sahha being the prime contributor to connected healthcare in Abu Dhabi, what, in your opinion, additional value did Malafi add? Mr. Bedr?
You can hear me now?
Yes.
I think Malafi has played a big role in connecting the private sector and the government sector to connect all these, sharing this information for that benefit for the patient and the healthcare provider. And it helped the caregiver to have better access to the patient history and making sure that the patient journey and the experience will be very simple, because they don't need to have repeat their test, their clinical procedure within visiting different healthcare provider. So I think it's good that we have a Malafi, and at ease and eliminate all the barriers between the healthcare, so that they have a good platform finding the all patient information and the history of the patient itself.
Well, Sahha is hosting thousands of doctors in Abu Dhabi from different nationalities. Some medical professionals believe that technology would interfere with their relationship with patients. How would you describe the response of UAE healthcare providers towards the implementation of digital healthcare solution? Is it more inclined toward acceptance or resistance?
I think we learned many of lesser learned from the pandemic that's happened here. And I think that because the technology is evolving and promoting that more services should be provided through as a remote services. And I think the adoption of these services become very high because people learn how to use these services as like telemedicine, teleconsultation, telepharmacy. So people being adapt for the new technology. And I think this is the future of the healthcare.
Excellent. I cannot agree with you more, Mr. Bedr. In my opinion, I describe digital healthcare is not simply a technological revolution, but a cultural transformation. As a concept, digital healthcare hugely relies on democratization of healthcare, which means bringing both the doctor and the patient to an equal level of relationship for shared decision-making. Dr. Hamid, currently, how will you describe the synergy between the end user and the system in Abu Dhabi? How is the public responding to it?
Well, first of all, I would like just to build on what Atif and Badr just mentioned. Certainly, Malafi is one of the building block for the digital health transformation. It's a key milestone for us in terms of where we want to be, Abu Dhabi to be in the future and being in the frontier of the adoption of the technology within the healthcare industry. Now, so what we aiming for when we introduce the technology, and as mentioned before, it is all has to be centered, anchored about the population. So people becoming the heart of the things that we are doing. So whatever technology that we are introducing, it has to come based on the needs and the wants of the society. We are not going after the technology by itself. We are going for making sure that technology solving the specific problems, specific frictions that's happening within the sector. And if we are able to capture the needs and the wants of the population, whether the healthy people or the people who are having some diseases, then we can co-design, co-create with them along with the other players within the sector so that we have solutions, technology that addressing their needs. So it's a little bit tricky when we speak about digital health transformation. And sometimes we think it's just a matter of bringing technology for the sake of having technology. Rather, our approach within for Abu Dhabi, and this is one of the anchoring points that I mentioned before, we want to be ahead of the game, but at the same time, being agile and being having a collaborative approach whereby we bring solutions that addressing specific needs and wants. And this is where we are heading. I mean, we put and we implemented and built Malafi. Now we also tackling about different building blocks that we're going to have that will bring together the patients and the physicians and the society altogether. So we adapted different kinds of solutions when it comes to predictive modeling, predictive analysis. So we are working in different fronts, and this is all coming through the collaboration that we tapping into the knowledge that is available within the providers. So I mentioned before that we moving ahead into a platform where the healthcare becomes on the platform. We have done initiatives. We launched what we call the AI lab 2 years back and during Darab Health. Initially it was a lab, a platform where people become and addressing specific problems and then they pitch for the good ideas. We have done hackathons in collaborations with the providers, with technology partners, that they themselves come up with the solution. Rather us, we as a regulator, we come up with the solution. We want the sector, the ecosystem, the main actors, along with the patient, to come up with the specific use cases, and then we tackle it. And this will make sure that whatever we do is really adding value to our population.
Thank you for this beautiful explanation. I think it's very evident to see the successful digital healthcare strategy evident in the various testimonials that we receive from patients and healthcare providers in Abu Dhabi. Again, as I keep saying, that Abu Dhabi is not new in the path of digital transformation. However, just like the rest of the world, in the beginning of 2020, the COVID-19 crisis came to disrupt many of our existing planning. Coming as a major challenge to humanity, it also COVID-19 put a massive strain on the healthcare system, and I'm sure it has forced to shift the attention from the current or the existing planned agenda. Alongside various challenges, ready access to patient data has been a common roadblock for healthcare providers, and this issue has been especially apparent during the COVID-19. Mr. Atif, what was Malefi's role to lessen the burden and to provide clinicians full access without barriers to patients' data?
Yes, so as you mentioned, I mean, this pandemic came as a surprise to the entire world. No one can say that, you know, they were ready for this pandemic. What I would say that Abu Dhabi was lucky with was that the Health Information Exchange Initiative, or Malefi, was already started. So the foundation was already built. And as you said, we were in the middle of the rollout program when the pandemic started. We then got a very clear mandate from the Department of Health to shift the focus and to focus on specific scenarios of, let's say, prioritization of certain onboarding activities to give you know, more support to the healthcare sector to manage this pandemic. So since the foundation was there, we had to accelerate onboarding of all the central labs that were doing COVID-19 tests. As you're aware, you know, the UAE government took a very clear strategy of maximizing the number of tests that are being conducted across the population. And that created the challenge when it comes to surveillance of either confirmed cases or lab results. So having a platform like Malefi helped us in making sure that we prioritize all the labs that were doing COVID-19 tests. Those that were already onboarded were able to easily make sure that data is shared with the public health department and give them the right level of visibility of managing the pandemic. Those labs that were not connected, you know, the Department of Health gave a very clear mandate for us to work very closely with them to prioritize the connection to Malefi. And I would say early on during the pandemic, we were able to centralize all the COVID-19 test results. That provided the right level of insights to the Department of Health to manage the pandemic more and to understand, you know, the spread of the disease across the community. At the same time, there were certain healthcare providers that were still not connected with Malefi, and they were seeing patients, and they wanted to coordinate care better with the different healthcare providers in Abu Dhabi. So we established a different instance where Malefi was available to access for those frontliners who were in need of accessing the provider portal in Malefi and to have access to the unified medical record of the patient. And also at the same time, we were also able to provide different tools and insights to specific entities that required, you know, to look at the lab results that were conducted on specific population and to know about the results of those patients. So all those, you know, we were able to move fast because of the foundation that was already built. And there was a lot of lessons learned that we had to go through during this pandemic, which hopefully will enable us to be more prepared for any future similar pandemic that Abu Dhabi might be hit, or globally.
I think,
Dr. Sana, may I add one point, building on what Atif just mentioned? Actually, I would say Abu Dhabi was ready in terms of managing the pandemic. We had plans how we deal with the pandemics. We had plans about how to deal with the emergency and crisis. And this is the work that luckily that we have people who anticipated that such a crisis, such pandemic, it will be hitting us. In fact, last year, we introduced a program for the foresight and scenario planning. And when we did the radar, we have seen that potentially a pandemic could happen. And though it's maybe very remote, but it is part of our capability building and having the embedded solutions, the embedded capabilities that we had in Abu Dhabi, where we explore the potential risk and this is going to happen in the future. So we had plans how to deal with the crisis and building on the crisis happened before. Abu Dhabi built a lot of assets within across the sector. And the good things that we have done in Abu Dhabi, we maybe we anchored the public institutions, but then we also opened up for the private sector to build the different assets. And hence, Malafi was instrumental in terms of connecting these facilities, but as well as we have other systems like Istijaba. Istijaba is another system that we have in the Department of Health. And this is a program, also a platform, focused around crisis. So this is also connecting essential data about the crisis and the beds and the different data elements that related to the crisis. So I would say we had different elements already in place within Abu Dhabi, and that what was enabled Abu Dhabi to be a pioneer and being very much responsive about how we've been able to manage the crisis in a better way. And we have seen the result that demonstrated itself in terms of the number of cases, as well as we have the least number of death that is happening within our facilities. And that all because of the different things that we have done in Abu Dhabi and building the right foundations, whether from the hospitals, as well as from the technology aspect.
Can I add on, Dr. Rahim?
Yes, please.
I think the time was a challenge. That pandemic hit the country, but we overcome that challenge because we have a good foundation and investment on the IT infrastructure as a foundation. And I think that mentioning that we able to build COVID screen center, and we able to setting up a field hospital fully automated that help to have a full EMR system that connected to the Malafi system, and connect also the private lab to our system that help to expand our testing capacity. And also we enable the technology for the frontliner that help and support them fighting that pandemic.
Excellent. I think by this, thank you for sharing this valuable information. I think this is one of the most valuable case studies probably during the pandemic for the readiness of any government or nation for such unprecedented crisis. I always mention that technology has always been helping us. It's really difficult to imagine where would we have been if not such collaborative initiatives have been launched. So continuing the same, while the COVID-19 crisis has generated a lot of challenges, as Dr. Hamid mentioned, it has also created opportunities, particularly in the digital healthcare sector. In your opinion, our esteemed speakers, what next can we expect from the health information exchange system? Probably telemedicine, or what do you think can be next? Can we start with Mr. Bedr?
Yes, I think that there is very important as opportunity with the Malafi system, because we can promote the population health there. I think also we can establish a solid platform for telemedicine. Also for another solution that we can apply AI that can detect and diagnose the patient that being visited to the healthcare provider. This is, I think, elements that need to be considered for the future investment.
Thank you, Mr. Bedr. Anyone else would like to add to this? What, in your experience or in your opinion, can we expect next from health information exchange systems? Mr. Atif or Dr. Hamid, would you like to add to this?
I can start with specifically about health information exchange. I mean, if you look at the broader term of digital health, definitely there are so many other opportunities. But if you talk specifically about a health information exchange, I mean, the opportunity that this pandemic showed is that data sharing for the purpose of coordinating care is definitely helping the various stakeholders. I mean, some people would have maybe asked about the importance or let's say, you know, question the value of having such a platform. But the pandemic really showed that having such a technology platform can help not just in the day-to-day care coordination, but even in doing surveillance of various diseases in a more proactive way and having a better visibility for you know, any future infectious diseases can be spreaded. Also, as Badr highlighted, getting better insights on the population and understanding the various risks of either new diseases, chronic conditions that can, you know, that can affect the health of the population. You know, getting better insights from the data that's available can drive better public health programs to prevent and manage those cases early on and ensure early intervention. So these are the, I can say, let's say the key opportunities in the future for a health information exchange.
Thank you, Mr. Atif. I think this is also opening many doors for innovators and even other companies to come and achieve. I have a very interesting question related to the same. That's why I would like to interrupt the panel. We have a question from Nood Al Hashimi. And this is, I think we can address this to Dr. Hamid. How do senior leaders create a sense of urgency for major healthcare system innovations, even without a pandemic? As you mentioned, you were that Abu Dhabi was ready for the pandemic even before it happens. How did you anticipate this?
Dr. Sana, I mentioned in the beginning that one of the anchoring points for us, Abu Dhabi, how we transform the sector is we want to be ahead of the game when it comes to digital health transformation. And we have done it in different ways. We, first of all, we established the right foundation, the capabilities in terms of making sure that we are capable to understand the changes that are happening with us, around us globally, and how we adapt and we bring this technology, not only bring the technology, but as well as contribute to the new technologies, the new solutions that will be coming to our population. And our leadership always setting a high standard, high expectations when it comes to the different, the expectation what we want to get from the healthcare and the healthcare. And the Department of Health is always responding, being responsive and progressive in terms of making sure that we always ahead of the game. And some example, building on the first question that it was mentioned about the remote care. And this is where it shows how Abu Dhabi adapting an agile and collaborative way of transforming the healthcare industry. During the COVID, we have been able to introduce a remote care application, an app. And within a couple of weeks of the crisis, actually in April, we worked with a technology partner to develop this remote care. And that remote care has been very much instrumental in terms of addressing one of the key elements of us and how we care about people. So whatever we do is always about our people, how to make sure that they're healthy and they're safe. And that remote care enabled the elderly and the chronic disease to connect to their caregivers through this platform, and as well as, and then we opened up also making it available for the rest of the society. So being agile, being responsive, being progressive is one of the elements that we making sure that this is embedded in our work environment, in our DNA as Abu Dhabi, as well as health when it comes to the transformation. And we have been being responsive, as I mentioned, through the remote care, but as well as in terms of the other solutions that already we are working on. And we highlighted different use cases that will be coming very soon and like the chronic disease, the disease registries, and our application of different AI tools that will be coming, will be introduced to the healthcare ecosystem.
Thank you, Dr. Hamid. I think you have pretty much answered very much, but I wanted to take the discussion even to elaborate further that COVID-19 is part of the crisis, while the healthcare industry remains very big. Chronic diseases, on the other hand, remain to be a major attention seeker of an unrivaled management program. So I want to ask any of the speakers who would like to answer this, what efforts have been made to maintain the other areas, such as chronic diseases, elderly care, apart from the pandemic crisis?
I can take it if I can take this one. Okay.
Yes,
sure. So during the COVID, you know, we many of the countries and also the focus was about the people who get infected. Now we have taken a big step in Abu Dhabi. Abu Dhabi introduced a program what is called the population at risk, and those addressing the elderly and the chronic disease that. Making sure, so what we have done, and this is the benefit of having the Malafi and other data sources that we have, that we have been able to identify people who has not been able to get care, those who are chronic disease, those who has not been able to get their medicine. And what we have done, we created a special program during the COVID, and now this program is going into different phases. And we it's like an experiment initially that addressing the those chronic and vulnerable groups to make sure that they don't get sick, but as well as how we can take care of them during the COVID. Now our thinking is about how to create a new model of care, a hybrid model, the traditional model of care, as well as the use of technology, how this will enable us to provide a greater value proposition to the chronic disease and those who are vulnerable when it comes to care. And hence, we introducing a model of care that it is a hybrid between technology and traditional. And the way we're doing it, again, and this is also building on one of the anchoring points that we are, our roadmap or the strategy of transformation is through co-designing it and co-creating it with the provider. So we are working with five different providers to anticipate or co-design and co-create this new model of care for chronic disease and vulnerable. They are coming with their own innovations. They are coming with their own ideas about what will be the future of model of care after the COVID and getting to the new norm where technology becomes an anchoring point make sure that we're having the desired outcome for our patient. So a lot of steps already been taken with specific to the chronic disease and a great lesson learned from this program that we have introduced. And as I mentioned, we are going into the third phase of the program in collaboration with five providers that I'm sure our people will benefit from it in the future.
And just to add to what Dr. Hamid said, when it comes to care coordination, when a patient has a chronic condition, it becomes even much more important. And we have seen this in different scenarios and feedback that we have received from different healthcare providers where patients with chronic conditions, they were moving for different treatments to different healthcare providers. And either they forgot, you know, to mention to the provider about their previous historical condition. You know, or they did not have, let's say, all the details that were required for the provider, but then the providers were able to access Malafi and understand the historical, treatment that this patient had. We had various stories from the healthcare providers on that, and that's where, you know, having an exchange can really help in managing patients with chronic conditions. When it comes to the patient themselves, you know, giving them access and making them aware about their condition through digital means and digital channels is one of the areas that Malafi today is working on to ensure that we provide the patients with that awareness and that insights about their current condition through an easy channels of access, digital channels of access. And when it comes to the public health department who are coordinating these public health programs, you know, giving them insights across the population, you know, that can be achieved by having a platform like Malafi, you know, to give those insights to the regulator and to drive public health programs in the community.
Thank you, Mr. Atif. But I would like to extend my question to you, Mr. Atif, that with any disruptive innovation, challenges often go hand in hand. And you know, people who are innovators might face challenges in research and development, standardization, and also building community awareness. For you, I believe that as you have very successfully implemented Malafi, and you're even now talking to us about the brilliant future plans, what do you think are the areas for future advancements? Are there any specific areas that we need to focus on? We have learned already that you are very focused on chronic diseases and elderly care. How do you think, or if you would like to advise the new innovators, what are the areas they're looking for? And what are the challenges that they should be looking for and how to deal with that?
Yeah, so I'll say maybe in the broader term of the healthcare industry, you know, healthcare industry is a bit behind when it comes to technology compared to, let's say, the banking or the other industries that, you know, had standards built when it comes to interoperability, when it comes to standardization of different communication mechanism. Healthcare globally, you know, has been behind in building those standards. Healthcare now is moving on to catch up so that to ensure, you know, technology is advancing when it comes to interoperability. And that's an area that we can see many of the technology partners are focusing on in ensuring that their technology is open, their technology is interoperable. Democratization of data is a reality today. You cannot have information blocking by, you know, monopolizing either specific areas of the industry. So having open standards is a key for any technology entrepreneur that is working in any technology in the solution within the healthcare sector.
Well, since the beginning, we're learning that patient centricity is the most essential pillar of an unparalleled digital healthcare strategy. Governments and regulatory agencies have a huge role in shaping people's attitude and approach towards technologies and innovation in general. My next question is for Mr. Bedr. What do you think are the major drivers to make the public believe in innovation and transformation?
I think our leadership, starting from leadership, better for moving from traditional clinical practice to move for digital practice. And they believe that data should be available for the patient anywhere and anytime. And they believe that we need to make sure that they have easy access and they can find their information available through the mobile application. So our role here is that we need to ease this process by implementing the value technology that help and provide the simplicity of using this technology.
I absolutely agree. The more simple and accessible the program can be, it will be easier for the public to deal with it. However, as we move to digital healthcare strategies, this movement always comes with a question about patients' privacy. Dr. Hamid, what are the preparations to maintain high level of individual personal data security?
Data privacy is very crucial, very important for us, and we have taken different measures around it. But before that, let me just build on the discussion that mentioned by Atif and the team in here, which is what's next when it comes to the for the healthcare industry, when it comes for digital health transformation. As I mentioned, Abu Dhabi and the Department of Health is committed to be ahead of the game and when it comes to digital transformation. when it comes to, we are committed as one to help to position Abu Dhabi on the technology frontier. And one of the anchoring points for us, one of the main dimension in our digital health transformation is healthcare on a platform. So where we are heading is creating another building block within the digital health transformation, whereby we creating the data platform, the data lake that will sit on top of the sector, bringing data sources from different data sources, and that will position us in terms of making data available for researchers, pharmaceuticals, and academic, and also for innovators to provide solutions and technology on top of this platform, in a sense, similar like a marketplace for the healthcare. And this is already, we have taken steps, and soon we are starting to build this platform in collaboration with some of the national champions that we have here in Abu Dhabi, that will build this data lake. They will build for us this platform. And this will be a game changer in terms of how the sector we're going to evolve and be transformed, not only by us as the developer, because we are only an enabler, but through the different players and actors within the system. And when it comes to data, certainly this is something that we embedded within our policy framework. So even when we started to work on the transformation or strategy for the healthcare, we embedded digital transformation, digital health within the framework of the policy making within Department of Health. So we introduced policies dedicated for use of AI. We introduced 3 weeks back a policy and a standard of the Internet of Medical Things. We introduced policies and standards with the specific about the use of telemedicine. And we also, we introduced policies about data privacy. And when we initiated and we worked closely with Melfi, not anybody can access this data. Only physicians will be able to access this information. Only a person when go and visit a patient in the consultation room, then the physician will be able to get access for that person data. Other than that, this is not feasible, it's not enabled, and we're ensuring that data is of a high, is very much secure, whether from the Melfi or from other solutions that we're going to introduce within the in the future. So we're tackling this and we're taking this very much seriously, complying with the different laws and the regulations locally and internationally.
Thank you. Mr. Atif, would you like to add to this answer? How is Melfi ensuring data privacy?
I think to add to what Dr. I mean, Dr. Hamad covered it well in terms of, you know, control is extremely, made sure that, you know, you can, that Melfi can only be accessed by physicians who are having a relationship with that patient. It is embedded within their electronic medical record. Every single transaction that is happening in the system is being monitored 24/7 to ensure that, you know, any misuse is caught early. Various controls, also more controls are being also put when it comes to sensitive data, so that to ensure that just basic information is available, and for medical reasons, if a provider needs to access the, some sensitive information, there is a very stringent process of breaking specific controls to get access to those sensitive data. So various controls are being put in place, and Melfi and across the healthcare sector, you know, whoever wants to connect to the platform needs to, you know, adhere to stringent security controls that can ensure that data is being protected. On top of the new data privacy standard that the Department of Health has published, and ensuring that all healthcare providers are putting controls when it comes to data privacy.
I think also patient privacy always a concern when we introducing any disruptive technology. But I think we should draw the line when we feel that there is an expose or a risk for the patient of the patient privacy. And I think we should be ensuring always that we are compliant to the security standard and protocol.
Thank you. With this, I would like to extend the question that health information exchange system, we are seeing a very successful case in Abu Dhabi as of now. But HIE systems are also opening new doors for cross-border cooperation. Finally, we can envision a borderless healthcare dream. It will definitely be helpful whenever the patients are traveling abroad to Abu Dhabi or elsewhere, getting remote consultation, etc. Mr. Atif, as a pioneer in HIE systems, what is your vision, or how would you see the way forward with cross-border cooperation?
Yeah, so maybe as I said at the beginning, the Medefi is built to ensure that the exchange is happening within the Emirates of Abu Dhabi, but definitely there will be cases where patients are moving either outside the Emirates to other Emirates within the UAE, or also internationally to other countries, or even the other way around, people coming to Abu Dhabi and then needing access to their medical record. So we're ensuring that our platform is interoperable. Today, there is already similar initiatives at the federal level and at the Emirate of Dubai. So how do we ensure that all these platforms are going to be exchanging medical records with the right level of controls to ensure that patients will always have their data available with them as they move across the UAE? Now, when it comes to globally, of course, there are various standards that have to be taken into consideration for data to become exchanged across the countries. But we are also empowering the patient by having their medical record always available with them through the digital channels that I have highlighted. So the patient will always be empowered by having their medical record easily available to them and to share it with their right level of control across the different international providers that they will be seeing.
Thank you. Mr. Bedr, where do we stand in Abu Dhabi healthcare? Considering the advancements in Department of Health and Saha with regards to international best practices of being data and digitally driven, how would you describe the position of Abu Dhabi in the global healthcare system currently?
I think we have a good foundation in terms of the technology, and I think we are, as Dr. Hamid mentioned, we are ahead of the game, and making sure that we search and explore more disruptive technology that add a value to the patient experience and improve the patient care.
Thank you. I would like to ask Dr. Hamid for the same question. How would you describe where Abu Dhabi is standing right now?
Well, Abu Dhabi addressing the different building blocks when it comes to digital health and technology. As I mentioned, we are ahead of the game. We have defined the different building blocks for the digital health transformation. We are one of the crucial foundation for us in building block is the platform that I discussed in a while, where we bring the whole healthcare into one platform. Hence, all the data elements, all the transactions will be coming into this platform. And that, as I mentioned, that will be a big game changer in terms of creating kind of a marketplace where different innovators, different actors can engage with this platform to provide solutions, whether a solution that directly being consumed by us as the round of health, or a solution that will be consumed by the providers, or addressing to the patient at large. And we are moving a lot heavily into the more of the prevention, as well as bringing when we want to take care about our patient, It's not about only the clinical, but as well as the social determinant. So we're going into an area where we're seeing that this platform and this advancement will bring the typical clinical and data and elements, as well as the social determinant, to have a better insight about the health of our the persons, but as well as have a better insight about the community. And hence, this will enable us to introduce public health programs that is more personalized and more addressing the specific need of each individual, and making sure that also the individual themselves are empowered to take care of their health.
Thank you. Excellent. I think with this, we emphasize further on that the role of technology in driving the transformation. I really believe that digital healthcare is not just a technology advancement, but it's a cultural transformation. With this, I would like to address the next question from one of our attendees to Mr. Atif. Mr. Atif Al-Breki, we have a question from Mr. Yusuf Ramadan. As more patients are utilizing digital healthcare services, are you considering changes to patient outcome KPIs that are impacted by digital medium of services versus the traditional face-to-face treatment or consultation? So I think this is just in continuation of Dr. Hamid's description of the cultural part and the personalization. Where do you see this? That how is the traditional face-to-face treatment versus the digital interface?
Yeah, so you know, Medefi is an enabler at the end to the caregivers, right, who are taking care of the patient. The more insights and information that we can provide them using different means, being it an on-site visit, being it a televisit, the more information you can provide to that caregiver, the better care will be provided to that patient, which will result in better outcome. This is the mandate for us to ensure that all the caregivers are coordinating care. This platform, its purpose is to ensure that this foundation is there. And this will lead to, as I said, you know, ensuring that better patient outcomes is going to be achieved for those patients who are, you know, being treated in the Emirates of Abu Dhabi.
Thank you. I would like to just encourage the audience, if you have any questions, feel free to share with us. I will take a couple of more questions. So we keep hearing new names of technologies, which are definitely changing. So, however, I would like to jump in with this question. So the question is addressing to Dr. Hamid from Mr. Mahmoud Jabbar. Are you considering blockchain technology to ensure privacy as a strongly secured for patients and citizens? I would like to add to this. So blockchain technology is there, IoT is there. Wearable devices are heavily being used to capture individual patient data. In general, Dr. Hamid, how do you think these technologies are going to be incorporated in the existing system?
Yes. There are different technologies that will have an impact and provide benefit to our the persons and the society. So it's not more about, it's not about the technology itself. It's about the problem that will be addressed. So if it is blockchain will address a specific problem and there is a use case for it, then certainly we are considering it. And actually we have a use case. We are working with one of the technology partner as well, where we introduce blockchain, but more into the insurance kind of a transaction, so that and the claims and all of that. So we are having a use case, and we're going to have a pilot actually around this use case very soon. And certainly blockchain will have different use in terms of the different areas. But it has to come from a specific issue or a friction or a problem that we need to address. Definitely we introduce, for example, a chatbot. We introduce machine learning, AI when it comes to predictive modeling. It all comes from a specific need or an issue that we want to address, that will have an impact in terms of the health and the safety of the people. So yes, blockchain is in our radar, and we implementing a pilot on the use of blockchain when it comes, but more into the insurance rather than into the health outcomes for our patient at this stage. But definitely, if there is a specific use where we can use blockchain, where it's going to have an impact on the outcome of the patient, certainly we are going to consider it.
Thank you. I think
to Dr. Hamid comments here is that technology is evolving through AI, through blockchain, but we need to assure that the value of this technology is achieved, because as my experience that some of these outcome was very modest. And I think we need to use to have use cases that prove that this technology will add value for health provider.
With that, my next question again to Mr. Bedar. So you have, in the beginning of the talk, you have quickly talked about telemedicine. In Abu Dhabi, how far are we from the reality of telemedicine and telepharmacy? Are you able to answer that at the moment?
I think we are now continue exploring about the telehealth and telemedicine. And we have some use cases that being used within the pandemic situation. And we prove that there is a value of having such a digital platform as teleconsultation. And I think we are exploring this technology with different areas so that we make sure that the value is being met and added to the better patient care.
Thank you.
May I add one element to it? Telemedicine is already, as Badr mentioned, it's already been applied. And Abu Dhabi is embracing the use of technology, whether it's telehealth or teleconsultations. We issued policies that enable and embrace the use of telemedicine and telehealth. And we are taking it into, and I mentioned in a while that we introduced remote care during the COVID. And we are encouraging the different players, different actors within the sector to adapt their own solutions while making sure that the patient safety, the data privacy is protected and according to the laws, the regulations that we have established. So it is something, yes, we are embracing it, and the way we see it is going to evolve much bigger. And in ourselves as Vantage Health, we are working on phase two of the remote care that we have introduced during the COVID. But it's more of a platform rather than to have one solution fit, one size fits all. We creating a platform where other players also introduce their own technology, where us having visibility in terms of the transaction during through this platform.
And I think we noticed that the pandemic accelerated the adopting of the patient using the new technology.
Yes.
Well, I'm very honored, first of all, to be with you. And unfortunately, we're coming to an end of our session. The topic is very, very diverse. And the fact that Abu Dhabi is definitely leading the way in digital healthcare does not make it easy for me or the attendees to just, you know, limit the discussion in 1 hour. However, all good things come to an end, and we hope to continue this discussion. Future talks. I would request our esteemed panelists that if I request you that in 20 seconds, what would be your message to the nation and to the public of Abu Dhabi about the bright future of digital health? Probably we can start with Dr. Hamid.
The main message I want us all to remember that Abu Dhabi dedicated to introduce technology, making sure that our people at the heart of everything that we do. So whatever technology that we introduce, it will have the positive desired outcomes on our patient.
Mr. Bedar, can we have your answer? What would you be your message to the public?
I think the technology is the future for the healthcare. and improving the patient care.
Thank you very much. Mr. Atif?
Yeah, from my perspective, Abu Dhabi chose the name Malafi, which in Arabic means my file, to pass the message that, you know, this record or this medical record is for the person itself, for the resident. They are the owner of this file. It is their file. And the patient will always be at the center of whatever is being done, being it at Malafi or across the healthcare sector in Abu Dhabi.
I think excellent to have a discussion with all of you, but very beautiful conclusion by Mr. Atif that Malafi, it actually makes the person itself feel the ownership of their own medical records. In the end, thank you all once again for joining, and big thanks to our esteemed panelists, Dr. Hamid Al-Hashimi, Director of the Strategy Division, Department of Health, Abu Dhabi, Mr. Badr Al-Qubaisi, Chief Information Officer, Abu Dhabi Health Saha, and Mr. Atif Al-Briki, Chief Executive Officer, Abu Dhabi Health Data Services, Malafi. We highly appreciate your efforts in improving the quality of healthcare and spreading the right information to the community. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you all.
Thank you. Thank you.